Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I want to talk about analyzing polls and a historical example about sampling methods. So when you're looking, somebody's telling you there's a poll. A lot of times we think about polls because they have to do with presidential campaigns or local elections or whatever, and they're saying, this person should get 45% of the vote with a 3% margin of error or something like that. But when you're hearing a poll, and something about a poll, you should be thinking about the sampling method. It should be a simple random sample. The confidence level should be provided. We have a 95% confidence that this poll is accurate, or whatever they're going to say. The sample size should be provided. And the quality of the poll results depend on the sampling method and the size of the sample. Population size is not usually a factor. And the size of the sample doesn't fix a bad sampling method. And I want to show you an example of that, talking about the 1936 election. So bear with me here, because this has the ending of it is pretty interesting. So in 1936, Alfred Landon ran for president against Franklin D. Roosevelt. The Great Depression was just ending, economic issues were a big deal, unemployment and government spending dominated the campaign. Literary Digest had been accurately predicting winners of the presidential election for 20 years. They had a nice, good track record. And so they predicted that Landon, who you probably never heard of, unless you're a history buff, would get 57% of the vote, and Roosevelt would get 43%. And that's the statistic that they were using, that they gave for the poll that they were measuring. The statistic, that's what they thought, based on their sample. The actual results were Roosevelt got 62% of the vote and Landon got 38. That's the parameters from the poll that the poll was trying to measure. That the parameter is the actual population from the voters. The statistic is the sample votes, the poll that Literary Digest did. That means that they had a sampling error of 19%, which is the largest ever in a major public opinion poll. And the crazy thing about that is that the Literary Digest poll was very large and very expensive. They had 2.4 million people in their poll, which is huge. At the same time, George Gallup predicted victory for Roosevelt correctly, and his sample was about 50,000 people. So what that shows is that large numbers do not cure poor sampling methods. They tend to compound the mistakes. And here's the mistake that Literary Digest made. They create a mailing list of 10 million names. They sent out 10 million blank ballots and asked people to fill them in and send them back. And from that, they determined who was going to get the votes. They found those 10 million names because they looked at every telephone directory in the United States. They looked at lists of magazine subscribers, rosters of clubs and associations, and other sources like that. And the downfall of this was selection bias, because remember I told you that they were talking about government spending and the Depression was just ending. And so who didn't have telephones in those days? Who couldn't afford magazines? Who couldn't be part of clubs and associations? Poor people. So when they sent out 10 million ballots, they sent out ballots to people that were automatically excluding those poor people who had a big axe to grind with the way things were going and cared about how things are going to get changed. That's the selection bias. And the other bias was non-response bias, because they sent out 10 million ballots and they got 2.4 million. But that's 24%. So that means a lot of people didn't answer. The people that did answer were the ones that had a really strong opinion, or just are, you know, feel guilt if they don't answer a survey or something. But most people didn't respond. So they asked a lot of people, but they asked the wrong people, and they didn't take into account that a lot of people hadn't responded. So pretty interesting case of sampling just gone awry that caused a bunch of humiliation, I would say. Okay, so based on our simple sample, we are 95% confident that 15% of the population will vote for candidate A with a 3% margin of error. So in question like this, they're saying, what's missing here? Well, they said, based on our simple random sample, we are 95% confident that 15% of the population will vote for candidate A But they didn't say how many people they surveyed. So missing in that is the sample size, right? And then what's the confidence interval here? Where they're 15% sure, but they might be 3% wrong. So that confidence interval will be 15 minus 3 is 12.12. And then the other side of that, you take 15, you add 3, and that would be 18 or 0.18. So this is their interval, their confidence interval. And they're saying, we think that's going to be 15%, but we want to go to either side by 3 to make sure that we're right. All right, have a fantastic day. Remember to subscribe if you'd like to see more of my videos. Have a great day.